Coronavirus is a respiratory virus that we've had in human populations for as long as there have been humans. It is possible for there to be new coronaviruses when somebody is around an animal that has an animal version of coronavirus, and then it's able to mix with a human coronavirus and sort of create something new, kind of like how influenza can do that. But then the challenge becomes that it's a new virus, and so the human immune system hasn't seen that virus before, and so then people are more likely to be contagious because they don't have a natural immunity already built up from prior exposure. So I think that's why we're seeing this new coronavirus moving quickly through different populations. So we definitely saw that in China, in that city and area of China where many people got infected very quickly. And then as this coronavirus has moved into different populations, then that process has then started to play out again. And I guess the example of that would be in Italy, where we're seeing widespread coronavirus infection because people don't have immunity, so it's more likely to spread through the community. And also I think in many other countries now, we're seeing widespread coronavirus. Also here in the United States, we're having spread particularly in Washington, California, New York City, for similar reasons. Somebody has a virus and is exposed to somebody that's not immune, and then the virus is likely to spread. The way the virus spreads is, as we have thought before, and like other coronaviruses, is it's a respiratory virus. So coughing, sneezing, it's in our phlegm and in our sputum. We think primarily this is what's called a droplet virus. So that means that these droplets generally fall to the ground within 3 to 4 feet. So that's why you might be seeing guidance about staying at least 6 feet away from each other, for example. That's where that comes from, is that's how droplets fall to the ground. There have been rare reports of probably people that are really sick, who are coughing and sneezing a lot, putting this coronavirus into the air in what we'd call an airborne manner. You know, that's a lot less common, but I think possible. So that's why within especially healthcare communities and different facilities that are caring for patients, you see this discussion about how to best protect patients and families and healthcare workers between airborne and droplet precautions. That's where that comes from.